Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lecture, we examined two ways in which quadratic functions can be written. These two common forms of a quadratic function are the general form and the vertex form. Regardless of its algebraic form, the graph of a quadratic function in a single variable is always a parabola. In the general form, a quadratic function of x is written as ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are constants that determine the shape and position of the parabola, while in vertex form, sometimes also called standard form, the constants are a, h, and k. In both of these forms, the constant a determines the width of the parabola and whether it opens up or down. But when sketching the graph of a quadratic function, it is also helpful to know the location of the parabola's vertex. When a quadratic function is written in general form, the coordinates of the vertex can be calculated using the constants a, b, and c. The vertex's x-coordinate is equal to negative b over 2a. And its vertical coordinate is the value of the quadratic function for that value of x. For example, the quadratic function x squared minus 8x plus 18 has values for the constants a, b, and c of 1, negative 8, and 18. Therefore, the vertex's x-coordinate, negative b over 2a, is positive 8 over 2, which is equal to 4. And the vertex's vertical coordinate is the value of the quadratic function for that value of x. We can calculate that value by substituting 4 for x in the quadratic equation, which gives us 16 minus 32 plus 18, which is equal to 2. On the other hand, unlike the constants b and c in the general form, in the vertex form, h and k are the actual horizontal and vertical coordinates of the vertex. This allows the coordinates of a parabola's vertex to be identified simply by looking at the function. For example, the horizontal and vertical coordinates of this parabola's vertex are 4 and 2. The reason h and k correspond to the coordinates of the vertex can be understood by thinking about how graphs can be mathematically shifted up and down or left and right. To shift the graph of a function vertically, we simply add a constant value to the function. For example, when we studied the function for a line ax plus b, we saw that when the constant b is 0, the graph passes through the origin. And when b is not 0, the graph is shifted b units up or down, depending on whether the value of b is positive or negative. Likewise, the graph of the quadratic function ax squared is a parabola whose vertex is located at the origin. And just like a linear function, the parabola can be shifted up or down by adding a constant value to the function. In vertex form, this constant is called k. So in vertex form, the parabola is shifted k units up or down, depending on whether k is positive or negative. Now, instead of shifting the parabola vertically, Let's say we want to shift it horizontally by h units. To shift any function of x, h units to the right, we replace x in the function with x minus h. But this seems counterintuitive. Why would subtracting h from x cause the function's graph to move to the right? To see why, let's start with a very simple quadratic function x squared, whose vertex is located at the origin. When x has a value of 0, the function f of x has a value of 0. And when x is 2, f of x is 4. Likewise, when x is negative 2, f of x is 4. Now let's see what happens if we subtract a constant value from x before we square it. For instance, let's see what happens if x is replaced with x minus 3. Now, when x has a value of 3, f of x is 0. So the coordinates of this point are 3, 0. When x is 5, f of x is 4. And when x is 1, f of x is 4. So by replacing x with x minus 3, the parabola has shifted 3 units to the right. But why? The reason is that since 3 is subtracted from x before it is squared, each value of x must now be 3 greater than before in order to produce the same values. Since the x values which created the parabola are now all 3 greater, the parabola is shifted 3 units to the right. So in general, if we subtract a positive value h from x before it is squared, the parabola will be shifted h units to the right. Likewise, when the value of h is negative, the graph will be shifted h units to the left. And remember that when h is negative, instead of subtracting a negative number from x, the squared term will typically be written as x plus a positive number. So to create the vertex form of a quadratic function, we start with the function ax squared, which describes a parabola whose vertex is located at the origin, and replace x with x minus h to shift the parabola h units to the left or right, depending on the sign of h. Then, by adding k to that function, the parabola is also shifted k units vertically up or down, depending on the sign of k. The horizontal and vertical coordinates of the vertex are therefore h and k. The method we have just demonstrated is not the only way to derive the vertex form for a quadratic function. In a later lecture, we will see that the vertex form can also be derived by a process called completing the square. In addition, quadratic functions written in general form can be converted to vertex form and vice versa. In the next lecture, we will create formulas to convert from one form to the other.